This video will show an example representing a simplified steel refining process in a ladle furnace to demonstrate the workflow of the Process Metallurgy Module, which was introduced in Thermo-Calc 2019b. This is the second example video about the Process Metallurgy Module. It is a standalone video, but if you would like to learn about the features of the Process Metallurgy Module, we recommend that you watch the first video in the series by clicking the link in the upper right-hand corner of the screen or by visiting the Video Tutorials page on our website. This example uses a demo database, so all users with a license for Thermo-Calc 2019b or newer can follow along on their computer. The example is based on example PMET-02, Ladle Furnace, which can be accessed from within Thermo-Calc in the Help menu, Examples Files, Process Metallurgy. Note that this example is not available for the demo or academic versions of the software, but other example files are included with those downloads. To begin, click on the Process Metallurgy template from the home screen of Thermo-Calc. Select the OX Demo Database from the drop-down menu. Set the temperature to 1,650 degrees Celsius. Next, we will define the steel. Set the amount to 100 tons. Click Show Composition, then click the green plus sign next to the major component to add another element. We will leave the first element as iron, and it will set automatically. Set the second element to carbon, 0.4 weight percent. Click the green plus sign again and set the third element to silicon, 0.5 weight percent. Click the green plus sign one last time and set the last element to sulfur with 0.08 weight percent. This automatically sets iron to 99.02 weight percent. Our steel is now defined, so we will save the material. Click the Save Material button, name the material steel_LF for ladle furnace, and click OK. Your material appears in the Material drop-down menu immediately and will be there every time you open the program. This could be a typical but simplified composition of a fully killed SAE 1040 grade steel. The sulfur content, however, is too high for most final applications and must be reduced. Sulfur is usually removed from the liquid steel in a ladle furnace using a calcium oxide-rich slag. Other steel refining processes are also carried out that can be investigated using the Process Metallurgy Module, but these will not be considered in this example. In this example, we want to find a slag composition that will efficiently desulfurize the steel. We are done configuring the steel, so I will click Hide Composition to keep the calculator neat and move on to the slag. For this particular calculation, we choose not to define a constant amount of slag, but instead use absolute amounts of components. Select kilogram as the unit, click Show Composition, and from the Input Type drop-down menu, select Absolute Amount. We will start with 2,000 kilograms of calcium oxide and add set units of aluminum oxide and silicon dioxide, which will increase the total amount of slag. Enter 2,000 kilograms of calcium oxide. Next, click the green plus sign to add another component. Select aluminum oxide and enter 250 kilograms. Click the green plus sign one last time and select silicon dioxide and again enter 250 kilograms. This gives us a total amount of 2,500 kilograms in the system. Select Save Material and name it slag_LF, then click OK. Again, I will hide the composition to keep the calculator neat. For this calculation, we will not consider the gas phase, so remove it by clicking on the red minus sign above the gas materials group. Note that this does not mean that no gas phase is allowed to form. It simply means that no gas phase is used to set the calculation conditions. We are now done setting up the conditions for the calculation, so we will move on to the calculation type. Select Grid. For the x-axis, choose Amount of aluminum oxide in the slag, with a minimum amount of 0 kilograms and a maximum amount of 1,000 kilograms. For the y-axis, choose Amount of silicon dioxide in the slag, with a minimum amount of 0 kilograms and a maximum amount of 1,000 kilograms. Leave the number of calculation steps as 10 for both axes in order to shorten the calculation time. With this setting, the calculation should be completed in just under 1 minute. The number of steps could be increased to maybe 30 by 30 for higher resolution of results, but this will increase the calculation time significantly, so you can decide to increase these numbers, but I will leave them as they are. What we are interested in is understanding whether our slag phase is liquid or not. So click on the plot renderer node, leave the plot type as contour, but under the z-axis, select fraction of liquid slag. At the top of the window, set the interpolation to 50 by 50 for a smoother looking contour plot. Finally, click perform to run the calculation. The resulting plot is very important for any process metallurgist. It shows that for low amounts of aluminum oxide and silicon dioxide, almost no liquid slag is present. Process metallurgists refer to this as a hard slag. Such a hard slag is in fact just solid oxide phases that passively float on the liquid steel. It does not react with the liquid steel for kinetic reasons and therefore will not desulfurize the steel. Practical slag compositions are limited to the top right field above the fraction liquid slag equals 0.9 contour line. Only here a liquid slag phase is present that can flow and can mix and react with the steel. Next, we are interested in the ability of the slag phase to remove sulfur from the liquid steel. We investigate this by creating another plot. Right-click on the Process Metallurgy Calculator node, highlight Create New Successor, and select Plot Renderer. Change the plot type to 3D at the top of the Plot Renderer window. For the Z-axis, select Composition of a Phase Group, Liquid Metal, and the element Sulfur. Then click Perform again. The red colors in the upper portion of the plot at high silicon dioxide and aluminum oxide contents show that the steel contains high amounts of sulfur. This means that only a little of the sulfur in the liquid steel partitioned into the slag phase and tells us that the slag phase has a poor capacity to take up sulfur. The blue colors in the lower portion of the plot indicate that the liquid steel contains only very low amounts of sulfur, so this would indicate a slag composition that is very effective at removing sulfur, or in other words, has a high sulfur capacity. But here it is important to remember, the performed calculations assume thermodynamic equilibrium, and as shown in the previous plot, there is in fact almost no liquid slag phase present in the lower left corner at low silicon dioxide and aluminum oxide contents. This means that thermodynamic equilibrium would not be achieved due to the very slow kinetics of the reaction between the liquid steel and the solid oxides. We can combine the two plots into one contour plot. Return to Plot Renderer 1 node and click the green plus sign to add another set of axes. Set the z-axis to Composition of Phase Group, Liquid Metal, Sulfur, and click Perform again. Combining the information contained in the two plots finally results in an optimum slag composition in a narrow composition band, which I have highlighted in yellow. Finally, we can map this optimal composition field by superimposing contour plots of sulfur content in the liquid steel and fraction of liquid slag in the following way. We want to have at least 95% liquid slag, so in the set of axis variables for fraction of liquid slag, check the box next to Use Custom Contour Values and set the value to 0.95. We also want to have less than 0.005% sulfur in the liquid metal, so check the same box in the other set of plots and set the value of sulfur to 0.005, then click Perform again. The optimal slag has a composition delimited by these two contour lines, so below the contour line for sulfur content in the liquid steel and above the contour line for fraction of liquid slag will be both fully liquid and will effectively desulfurize the steel. To watch additional videos about the Process Metallurgy Module or other calculators in Thermo-Calc, click the links in the upper right-hand corner of the video or visit our website at www.thermocalc.com.